My name is Gary Raposa, and I'm an application engineer here at Agilent Technologies. So today, I'd like to talk to you about providing power to a microinverter. And this is an example of a microinverter. It's an M175 from Enphase Energy. Provides about 175 watts of power. And microinverters are used in between a solar panel that might be installed on your roof, and they provide power to the electrical appliances in your home. And this is a grid-tied microinverter, so its output needs to be connected to the grid, the AC that's provided by the power company in your neighborhood. So we'll also take a look at some demonstration software that I have here. And what we'll be doing is, instead of using an actual solar panel that would provide power to the microinverter, Agilent has a solar array simulator, which is this box here on the top. And I also have an AC source that I'll be using as a grid simulator down here below. These instruments have fans in them to keep them cool, and we will be providing several hundred watts of power. So I'm going to turn them on, and you'll hear some fan noise in the background. So I've turned the instruments on, and now we've got the solar array simulator and my grid simulator both performing, where the solar array simulator is providing power and the grid simulator is also providing power to some light bulbs I have set up on the side here as an AC load. I've also got some demonstration software that I'll show you, and I can control the solar array simulator with my demonstration software. So let me show you what's happening here. In real life, we would have a solar panel collecting energy from the sun. In this case, the solar array simulator is simulating the output of what the solar panel would put out. So in real life, that solar panel would provide the input power to the microinverter, and the microinverter takes the DC output of the solar panel and turns it into AC and feeds it onto the grid or to the appliances in your home. Again, in this case, instead of the solar panel, we're providing power to the microinverter with my solar array simulator. So I've got the SAS, the solar array simulator, and the micro connected to the microinverter, connected to my simulated grid, and then finally onto some light bulbs I have as my real load. So the graph here shows the output of the solar array simulator, which would normally be the output of a solar panel. And on the left side, it's current. The horizontal axis is voltage. So this blue curve, you may not be able to see the color on the screen there, but the blue curve, this one, is the IV curve. And the green one, this one, is the power curve. It shows power versus voltage. So at this particular point in the IV curve, the red crosshairs, if those are coming out, are showing the present operating point on the SAS. So you can see that it's operating right at the knee of the power curve, and that's the maximum power point. And that's actually the job of these microinverters. The job of the microinverter is to harvest as much power as possible from a real solar panel that would be mounted on your roof. In this case, it's harvesting that power from our solar array simulator. So let me show you what would happen if we get some more cloud cover. I can actually, with my demonstration software here, I can move the cloud in front of the sun. And what that does is it moves the IV curve down and it reduces the amount of power that would be available from a real solar panel. Again, in this case, we're simulating that with the SAS. And we're changing the IV curve. As I move that cloud, I'm actually programming the IV curve down on the SAS. And the red crosshairs always end up right at that maximum power point because that microinverter is doing a really good job of regulating right at that maximum power point. When I move the cloud back out of the way of the sun, the amount of power that's available goes up. The microinverter is able to detect that, and it's able to move the maximum power point and the operating point right back to the peak of the curve, because that's what its job is to harvest as much power as possible. So another thing I'd like to point out to you is what happens with the power here. We've got a constant amount of power flowing into the light bulbs I have set up on the side, about 242 watts. And that total power has to come from either the solar array simulator or the grid. The sum of these two, minus a little bit that's dissipated in the microinverter itself, the sum of those two has to equal that total load power, which is constant. So for just a moment here, I'm going to put this on an automatic cloud movement mode, and that'll move the cloud automatically. And you can see as the sun is being blocked, the power available from the SAS is reduced and it goes down, which means the power that comes from the grid has to go up to equal the total power here. Now the sun is coming back out again. The simulated solar panel power is increasing, so the grid power is decreasing. Obviously, this is the desirable situation because you're paying for the utility power coming from the grid, yet what's available from the sun is virtually free. So we've just seen how we can provide input power from an Agilent solar array simulator to a microinverter. Now, normally the microinverter would be tested by the manufacturer either in a design environment or perhaps a quality control environment or even in manufacturing, where the Agilent solar array simulator is the ideal instrument to provide that input power to the microinverter in order to test all of its various attributes.